Hi everyone, it's Jake. Thanks to everyone who's been posting on the Small World Facebook page. If you have any questions for us, please feel free to ask away. Last video, we were isolating single strains of bacteria using a technique called streaking. Now, after several rounds of restreaking to ensure that the bacteria is pure, this is the isolate from number 10 Downing Street. Now, we're fairly certain that this bacteria is Streptomyces, but we can't be sure until we've analysed the DNA. The only trouble is we don't have enough. Even if we took all the bacteria from this plate, there still wouldn't be enough. So we're going to use a technique called PCR to make more copies of the DNA.
DNA is like a long chain made up of four different chemical units. Each unit is like a letter and a code, and the code is like a set of instructions. You've probably heard that the structure of DNA is a double helix. What this means is that DNA is actually made up of two strands twisted together. DNA is found in all living things, from bacteria to plants and animals, and contains all the information needed to build and run an organism from scratch. PCR lets us amplify a section of the DNA code, which we might be interested in. When we use the PCR technique, we use an enzyme called polymerase that all living beings use to replicate their own DNA. PCR stands for the polymerase chain reaction. PCR runs in cycles. With each cycle of the reaction, the enzyme will double the amount of DNA. As you can see, after just four cycles, we have gone from one piece to 16 pieces of DNA. We run this reaction for 40 cycles, which gives us over a trillion pieces of DNA. So you can see just how much DNA we need before we can analyse it.